Welcome to Rotary and Serving Our Community. My name is Wade Nomura, and today we have a special show. We're going to be looking at youth at risk and how Rotary is making a difference in that area. With me today, I have Bob Kingston with the Rotary Club of Carpinteria Morning. I have Ann Cowell from CADA and Kim Davis from CASA. Bob, I'm going to start with you since you're the Rotary guy right now. Tell us a little bit about you.
Well, thanks for having us, Wade. I'm a man that came to Carpinteria and joined Rotary about 21 years ago. I bought a little business in Carpinteria, and the owner of the business had been in Rotary, invited me to lunch, and I enjoyed it immediately and became part of that community. I grew up in a family that had a lot of experience working with the community. My mother started the first chapter of the League of Women Voters in the 50s in New Jersey. And also in California, she started the Young Mothers, one of the first Young Mothers programs for high school, pregnant high school girls. And so I grew up in a family that was very active in the community. And Carpinteria is a very easy community to become active in.
Great. Now, I believe you're current president of your club also, right?
It took him a long time.
A long time.
But I'm finally president.
Yeah. Were you kicking and screaming that whole time, or what?
I didn't realize I'd be this old by the time I got here. But I'm enjoying every minute
of it. Sounds good. Great.
And the reason we're here today about youth at risk, and it's interesting how this whole thing works. The history of me a little bit and why youth at risk is such a big part of my interest is that I adopted two boys, so I got involved with what it was like to adopt and the challenges of children. I was also on the board at the Salvation Army, where I saw they had the rehabilitation center in Carpinteria, and I noticed how many of those gentlemen in there were foster kids or from really rough childhoods. So I've realized all along what a challenge that is to us as a community. And in the last 6 months, I was introduced to Noah Benshi. He is the Justice Department gentleman, through Jack Hurley in the Carpinteria community. Jack has had 34 foster kids, and I've been very friendly with him, and he introduced me to Noah and said, you guys have a similar passion, and through Rotary. So I met Noah, and we hit it off immediately. We had the common bond of just wanting to make the world a better place, and starting with our youth, because that's where it all starts. And if we can clear that up and make that a better world, we'll make the world a better place. So Noah, well, I had this vision of going to Rotary, because Rotary is in every community, and Noah and I have spent a lot of time together. And then Ann came to speak to us at the Rotary Club, and it's funny how things work. Noah and I have a saying that there's no coincidences, and it wasn't a coincidence that shortly after I met Noah, Ann showed up to speak on behalf of the CADA program, and we hit it off immediately and realized that we could really start something big here. And every community in the country has a challenge with youth at risk, and so we think that Carpinteria is a perfect community because of the ownership and the smallness of it. Everybody knows everybody, that we can make a big difference and take this to other Rotary clubs throughout the country. And then I've met Kim, who's got a passion for this thing also through CASA, because we also came aboard on part of our project, and I'm going to shut up after this part. Part of our project, we met through Noah. I met Michael Biota, who is the ex-CEO of CASA, and he's in our steering committee. And it's just everything's come together, and I think we're going to make a huge difference, not only in Carpinteria, but in the country as a whole.
Sounds good.
So I'm very excited about it.
Thank you. Ann, how about you? Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I am a Santa Barbara native, and actually spent a lot of time in Carpinteria growing up, so I have a particular passion for all of this. But I went to Santa Barbara High School, left for college, went to the East Coast, and then had to come back to Santa Barbara because I loved it so much. And that's when I got involved with my job at CADA. And I'm the director of their Fighting Back Mentor program. And then also recently became the program manager for the Santa Barbara Teen Court. And both of these youth programs are so important to me personally because, you know, like Bob said, there's such a need for support for at-risk youth in our community. And these two programs are kind of at two different levels to support these youth. You know, the mentor program is really coming in at the base of that early prevention, education support for youth who are vulnerable but not yet participating in negative behaviors. And so we can really give them a mentor who can help them right before they get to that kind of split in the road. And then the Teen Court program is an early diversion program. So it's kind of restorative justice. You know, if a youth makes a silly mistake, as we know teenagers often do, and they get cited for something, they can go to teen court, get judged by a jury of their teenage peers, and go through a process of education, restitution, community service, and a variety of other projects that can really help them learn from their mistakes and be a better person moving forward. So I'm really excited to have met Bob by presenting to Rotary about the mentor program right when he was already excited about collaboration around serving our youth. And I was kind of having a similar idea, and we sat down right after I presented, and we pretty much both said the same thing at the same time. And then we looked at each other and said, wow, what a coincidence. And he said, there's no such thing as coincidences.
It's God's way of remaining anonymous.
That's exactly what he said. And that was the beginning of this very exciting project. And really what we're trying to do is get the community of Carpinteria to band together around our, you know, most vulnerable, most at-risk youth that really are going to be the future of the community. And they are kind of a tipping point where if we can give them what they need to be healthy and successful, we're gonna see a huge change in our community moving forward. And so it's amazing that Rotary has taken so much ownership of this issue, and they've really come in and said, you know, we are gonna make this happen. You know, we know that you guys are so busy that we're always running around like crazy just trying to make our programs run. And so Rotary is just taking such a step forward to really be the face of this project, and it's really exciting, and I think it's going to make a big difference.
Good. So what does CADA stand for?
Great question. I always forget about the acronyms running around in the nonprofit world. CADA stands for the Council on Alcoholism and Drug Abuse.
Okay.
And it's really very broad. CADA actually has 26 different programs, and they range from early prevention, which is what the mentor program is, you know, and that we're really general support, and helping youth become resilient to negative influences includes drug and alcohol, among a variety of other things. And so CADA has prevention programs. We have early intervention programs for youth and teens like Teen Court. We have treatment for youth, treatment for adults, detox, aftercare, across the entire spectrum. So it's really a full service organization.
Great.
Yeah.
Do you do specific breakdowns between the youth and adult programs, or is it kind of blended together?
It's definitely specifically broken up. We don't like our youth programs and our adult programs to be interacting too much. We want to make sure that all of our, you know, clients, all of the people that we're trying to help, are getting the most individualized service possible, because that really makes it a lot better for them and also easier for us to make sure we're doing the best job possible.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Kim, how about you? Tell us about yourself and your program.
Well, I want to start out, Wade, with thanking Bob and Rotary in general for involving CASA in this project. It's really going to be a very exciting thing to be a part of as we help to make our communities healthy. And at CASA, which, by the way, stands for Court-Appointed Special Advocates. I knew you were going to ask that. And CASA of Santa Barbara County has actually a really long history partnering with Rotary. In fact, the Santa Maria Breakfast Rotary and their Noontime Club were actually the pioneers of our Kids Fund, which enables us to do so many things, special things for kids. And I actually give them a tremendous amount of credit for helping us to grow and expand CASA throughout the whole entire county. And over the last 7 years, we've more than tripled the number of children that are served with a court-appointed special advocate. So it's a wonderful partnership, and I just see this opportunity to grow the opportunities in Carpinteria as a real extension of that, and a very exciting partnership. So that's a really exciting thing. I wanted to make sure and extend my thanks to all Rotarians. We have several CASA volunteers who are Rotarians, and so I would be remiss if I didn't. I can't name them because I'm sure I'd miss somebody, but thank you to every Rotarian who serves as a CASA volunteer as well. It's a great opportunity. It's a way to really be involved in a child's life where you're changing the trajectory of a child's life forever. And you know, when you step it back and realize that every day in our country, 1,900 children are victims of abuse and neglect, and five of them will die every day. And this is a problem that is not, it doesn't exempt Santa Barbara or any other community. This is a problem that exists in every community. So I can't think of any organization more powerful than Rotary, who is in every community, to partner and say, you know what? We're going to stand here for the kids, and we're going to do something now that will make a change forever, because you change one life, and that is just going to start a ripple that's going to change things forever. And we know that it works. We know that whatever mentoring program you get involved in, whether it's CASA, whether it's the mentoring program at CADA, or so many other great mentoring programs that are available, you get involved and you make a difference that, I mean, you want to talk about changing your community. If you want to change the landscape of your community, this is how you do it. You make the life of a child safe and secure without abuse and without the drugs that might afflict their parents. And you're really going to see incredible change in your community.
Great. Now, do you by any chance know Scotty Ortiz?
I do know Scotty Ortiz, just a little bit, as long as your name dropping.
Yeah, I'm dropping one name. She would appreciate it, by the way.
Scotty Ortiz is just a phenomenal woman who served as a CASA volunteer. And then I know that she went out throughout the Rotary programs and shared her very touching story of her experience as a CASA volunteer. Right. She probably has single-handedly recruited more CASA volunteers. It's the power of Rotary. And the other thing I have to say is Rotarians are very famous at our CASA at the Vineyard event, where it seems like it's a lovely time for Rotarians to gather and support CASA by attending our event. But they're a fun bunch, let me just say that. Sometimes we get a couple of different Rotary clubs, and all of a sudden we've got a great competition on our hands. So Scotty and her gang, I think they bring about 2 tables every year, right, at least, and it's a lot of fun.
That's great. Now, you were a Rotarian for a while, weren't you?
I was a Rotarian. We were talking about this, and I absolutely love the mission of Rotary. And I dropped off because my job demands have me running all over the county, and I did not like the feeling of being a flake. So now I'm learning a little bit about this e-club possibility, where I might be able to get back involved and then see it from a different angle, and I'm really curious about that.
Sounds good. You touched a little bit on the problems that you've seen. Could you elaborate a little bit more on what you see as the actual problem and why we're addressing this youth at risk?
You know, at CASA, we serve youth literally from 0. And people go, what does that mean exactly? That means a baby that is born probably drug addicted at the hospital and is removed from their parent. And we serve children at every age range, right up through age 21 now. So we help them with their transitioning age. You know, I'm no longer a child. Now I've got to figure out how to be an adult in the world when I haven't had maybe the best quality parenting. So the problems that we have is the children that CASA serves have not gotten in any trouble. They haven't broken any laws. They've done nothing wrong, and they're victims of the circumstances and sometimes the unfortunate choices that their parents might have made. We have in our community an incredible problem with drugs, as I know Ann knows all too well. And a lot of times people get caught up in the fact, oh, we've got this drug problem here. But what they miss is that the silent victims are the children. And when children are left in that chaos, we have our choice as a community. You can leave children in chaos, and all they will ever know is a culture of drugs. Or you can get involved in that child's life and show them that there's so much more in the world and so much more resources available to them, and you can help those children become safe. And I think, you know, there's so many organizations, especially Santa Barbara's abundantly blessed with organizations helping to solve so many of our societal problems. The problem with drug abuse of the parents of our children is massive. It's far bigger than what I could even fathom how to fix. But what I know is that when you put a responsible, caring adult in the path of a child who is otherwise at risk, you can change things forever by that caring time that they spend to make sure that child is safe. And I think that's exactly what this organization, and I'm so excited about Rotary getting involved to say, hey, let's make our community safe. Let's make some changes that are going to last forever by encouraging more people to step up and be a mentor, be a CASA. Find the thing that works for you to be involved and be a part of the problem. There was a judge once who said, this is a community problem. And if it's a community problem, who do you look to? You look to the community to solve it. And anytime if I think that I need to look to the community to solve something, about the first thing that comes to mind is, where's Rotary? And so this, it seems like a perfect match to me to have Rotary stepping up to say, you know what, we're going to make children's lives safer.
Great, thank you.
Yeah, that's, go ahead. Do you want to start again?
I would love to tag along to that. So I really agree with everything that you said. And we were talking before the show about how our two programs are really on a spectrum of mentoring, you know, and that there are so many youth in need in our community, and they're all at various levels of need, you know, and the CASAs are really serving our most vulnerable youth who, for no fault of their own, have suffered in really a variety of ways and are in foster care and just in such great need. And then my program, the Fighting Back Mentor Program, I guess one of my programs now, is a little bit lower on the spectrum of need because our youth are third through eighth grade students, and rather than being in foster care, they are identified by their school because they are at risk. And what that means to us is that these teachers or school counselors are noticing that there are kids in their classroom who are really struggling in school behaviorally, maybe academically or socially, often because of things that are going on in their environment. So a lot of times it's stress at home. They may have a single parent who's working very hard, is not able to give them, you know, enough one-on-one attention. They may have an unsafe neighborhood. They may have a parent or both parents who are struggling, you know, with their own issues with drug and alcohol. Or they may just be really having a hard time in school and their parents can't support them with their work. They may be very shy and having a hard time making friends. You know, the list goes on and on of what might be the root of the issue for these kids. But the teacher or the counselor who knows them says, you know, this is the time in the student's life where if we can pair them with a positive adult mentor, we can change their life forever because they can have someone who's stable. They can have someone who's there just for them, who thinks that they're special and they're great, you know, and comes in and says, high five, so excited to hang out with you today. You know, what do you want to do? Let's play a game. Let's talk. Let's do some homework. You know, let's go for a hike. I actually just did a match meeting today with a little girl, a little fifth grade girl and her new mentor, and we were making goals about the things that they could do together. And she said, I really want to go for a hike. And I said, that's great. And she said, yeah, I've never gone for a hike before. And she's lived in Santa Barbara her entire life, never gone hiking. So these kids just don't have the opportunities that we consider to be normal, that every child grows up going to camp, going for hiking, going to the beach. But that's just not the case for so many kids, and we don't often see that. So it's really important that you guys are bringing the message out that these kids are out there, and it's so easy for us to serve them. You know, we just require a mentor to come in 1 hour a week for a minimum of 1 year, and that's it. You do, you know, one lunch hour a week, and you go to school, and you meet with your mentee, and you have fun, and you're their friend, and you support them, and you will change their life forever. And it's so powerful, and it's just very exciting, and thank you. Thank you so much to Rotary for, you know, making this collaboration possible.
You can feel the enthusiasm.
Well, I was waiting for you. You're jumping out of your seat here, Bob.
These women can talk. Yeah, really, yeah. No problem with that.
You're right.
I was a mentor a couple times, and it was a big deal to me. And the community of Carpinteria is going to be an ideal place to make this happen. I've already spoken to the superintendent of schools, the principals, the coaches. I've got the theater arts people lined up. I got the art people. All these people that want to get involved to make a difference in these kids' lives. Because having been a mentor, it's not just being a mentor. It's getting a support group that gets you the kid to find out what else he's interested in, get involved in those activities. And the community is on board big time. I'm just excited beyond belief. And these two gals are making me a lot more excited. So
great.
Rotary, it's a match made in heaven. I mean, we are the community, in every community in the country, Rotarians are the movers and shakers, are people that can make a difference in that community. And you and I know as Rotarians, it's going to be nice to do something in the United States, in this country, that we can address all the problems that we have in these kids later in lives. We can go and be a solution to clear them up before they get started. Mm-hmm. I mean, one last thing, that they predict the number of prison beds they're going to need in California by how many kids are in foster care or youth at risk. 70-80% of them are going to end up in prison. We have a chance to stop that cycle.
In Rotary, we have what's called a Rotary moment. And that Rotary moment is that one time where you understand what the big picture is and how you made a difference. Did you have that in this type of youth at risk area?
Oh, it's unbelievable. I mean, I use that word coincidence, but I met Noah, then I met Jack Hurley, and the whole thing's coming together. 2 weeks later, Ann's speaking at Rotary.
Yeah.
And we hook up, and it's just everybody in the community I've talked to says, I want in. They're buying into this, and then Kim, what a great addition she is. And I'm just really, really excited, and I think we can make a huge difference, and we'll be able to take what we learn in Carpinteria, expand it to Santa Barbara and throughout the country.
Great.
Because everybody's looking. It's an unbelievable opportunity. And with your guidance, Mr. Namura, I have to be nice to you.
Thank you.
But you've helped to steer this thing also and make us aware of what we have to do to make this thing work. And I appreciate that very much.
Thank you. How about you, Ann? You had any personal experience that really bonded you to the program?
Oh my gosh, endless, honestly. But I think I have to start with my own experience as a mentor. I just celebrated my 5-year matchiversary, is what we like to call it.
That's cute.
Okay.
I like that.
With my own mentee, and it's just so exciting. You know, I started with her when she was just beginning her 8th grade year in junior high, and then this last year she graduated from high school, and now she's in her first year at City College, and you know, she wasn't sure if she was even going to make it there, and I'm just so proud of her, and we've had so many experiences throughout our relationship that bring home, you know, how rewarding it is to be a mentor, how much fun I have, how I find my cheeks hurt after I spend time with her because we've been laughing so much. But I think kind of the first moment when I realized how powerful mentoring is and how working with youth is so important was kind of a silly thing. It was maybe, I think, 6 months after I had been meeting with her once a week at her school, and I used to bring lunch, and we would share lunch together and talk and do little activities and just, you know, we're becoming friends. And about 6 months after that, we were sitting down to lunch, and she turned to me and she said, you know, Anne, you're the only one who gets me to eat my vegetables. And it was kind of such a silly thing, but it made me realize that I was the only person in her life who was influencing her in that one small way. And that translated to so many other things that I realized throughout our relationship, and definitely now, that she has said, you know, you have been the only person who's influenced me to do this or to do that or to try something new or to eat vegetables, whatever it is. And it's just really incredible. And I hear stories like that from all of the mentors in my program. And it really is so powerful.
Kim.
Well, I have to say the same thing. I could find so many, but, you know, every time I hear one of our volunteers share a story, it's like a moment for me. And just the other day at a volunteer meeting, I had one of our gentlemen who has been volunteering with us for about 8 years. And he came up and he was so excited. He wanted to show me a couple of pictures of him and his young man. And this little boy had been bounced out of 3 foster homes already, and he was just too rambunctious, and he kept, you know, just too much for anybody to handle. And everybody said he just could not sit still. And the picture was of the two of them fishing. And that was a still child. And so I think that there's such a beauty in the CASA volunteer in that they are so invested, and they're going to find, you know, what works for that child? How can I engage that child in an interest? You know, what is that child's need? Maybe it's that one-on-one special time. But that picture where that child was so engrossed in learning to fish, something that had never, ever come his way, and that was so special. For me, with the organization, I also started as a volunteer. I guess there's a theme there. And I was sharing with Bob a story about one of the children that I advocate for, and he had been placed in a home where two previous foster children had been medicated with ADHD drugs. And he had never been diagnosed with any of that kind of need, and yet this parent, this foster parent, was demanding that he be placed on drugs. And when I met with him to ask him, I said, what should we tell the judge? And he had three things. Tell him, no drugs, absolutely no drugs. I do not want to take drugs. And I was able to be his voice and tell the judge that we were not doing drugs.
That's great. For me, personally, I've been doing youth sports and coaching youth for my whole life, entire life. Even when I was in high school, I was coaching. The unfortunate part that I've seen in youth and the way they develop is those few instances. I've actually had six youths that I have lost by taking their own lives.
Oh, wow.
And that is probably one of the most tragic, with the exception of those that waste their life away because they just can't find the direction. Mm-hmm. So I sure appreciate what you're doing. Real quick, if you can give me a real quick wrap-up, how do you think Rotary could get involved?
Well,
what could you do? What would somebody do to get involved?
Well, that's why we're having a big town hall meeting in Carpinteria to make it. We call it a town hall meeting to bring the community, and I think we're going to have a huge number of people there. And everybody I talk to is excited about it. And Rotary, through the number, what do we have? 80 or 90 Rotarians in Carpinteria,
right?
And I've spoke to the other club, and they're all going to bring a number of people. And I have not been to one, talked to one person or not anything that they just want to be on board. They realize that this is one legacy that we can leave and make the world a better place. And Carpentry is just a great place that I think we're going to have the ability to make a huge difference and take it to other clubs.
Good. So if somebody wanted to get involved, they can contact Kata, Casa. We'll have those contacts out there.
Yes.
Depends how fast the response they want.
I have to do a shout out because the Fighting Back Mentor Program is
desperately
looking for volunteer mentors right now. So I would love it if people could contact me. You can email us at mentorprogram@kadasb.org. That's CADASB.org. I got to spell it out. Or you can also call us at 805-963-1433, extension 113, because we have 40 kids right now on our waiting list to get a mentor, and there are many, many more that are just waiting to be on the waiting list. So the need is huge.
Great. Well, thank you, everybody, for coming, making a difference in our world and our communities, youth especially. That's the future, our future. Our future leaders and everything we can do. So again, Kata, Casa, thank you very much. And I'm glad Rotary could be a very good part of this one. We're looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.